You're listening to Marketing Tips with Meliss podcast.
Welcome to Marketing Tips with Meliss podcast. And now your host, Meliss Jakubovic.
Hey, everybody. Today we're talking about how you automate your email system. This was a question that came up in one of my groups, so I wanted to address it because I know a lot of you may have this question. Email automation is an amazing strategy to use because you are able to communicate with all of your prospects, all of your customers, all of your clients in the same fashion so that every single person that walks through your digital door will get the same experience. I want you to think about a chain food restaurant. Maybe it's a pizza shop in your area. When you go in to one of the shops or another one of the shops, you're going to get the same menu. You're going to get the same ingredients. You're going to get the same type of service. You know the food's going to taste the same. You know that the bill is going to be a certain amount for that amount of food if you get the same thing at each place, and you walk out satisfied because you were expecting something and you received it, and you're going to get the same exact thing every single time. When you have email automation, the same thing happens for your customers. They're going to be able to talk to you. You're going to be able to talk to them, and no one's going to fall through the cracks. So email automation is really, really important. And I talk about that in a few of my other podcasts. But this question is specific to how do you automate your email system? And for starters, you need an email management system. I prefer MailerLite. It's MailerLite. You can use MailChimp. You can use Constant Contact. You can use Entreport or Aweber. All of these systems have different pros and cons, and some are more robust than others. So it really depends on your needs. But you need to have an email automated system, management system. But you need to have an email management system in order to send out emails automatically. The next thing you need to do is brainstorm what it is you're going to talk to your audience about. Why do they need to be on your email list? What are you going to send them that's going to make it worthwhile, where they're going to want to stay on your email list and get information from you? And the answer is you're going to be sharing your expertise. So it also depends what type of business you're in. If you're in a type of business where you can teach, then you want to share that expertise in a teaching style fashion. If it's the type of business where you're selling product, then maybe you just want to showcase your newest products of this season. So decide what it is you want to share with your audience. Part three, write your emails. You're going to need to connect with your audience in the language that they use. You want to speak to your audience in a casual way. I think the more casual you are, the more mistakes that you show, like maybe some punctuation, maybe a spelling error here or there. Now that's counterintuitive, but it makes you more real and it makes that experience deeper. You're really building the relationship when they know that behind this email is not a robot, it's a person. So you want to write your emails and you want to use the language that your ideal target market is using. Don't use big fancy words to impress them. Use language that you know they will get. You want to think about writing a letter to your best friend. Who is your business bestie? And that's who you're going to write your email to. The next thing you want in your email is a call to action. Tell them what you want them to do. Do you want them to read all of this? Do you want them to reply to you? Do you want them to purchase something? Do you want them to click on this? Do you want them to watch a video? Give them something to do. So there's value and then there's continued value. That email is valuable and the call to action brings them to something else, more value. And don't be scared to give away some of your greatest content because people are going to be so thrilled with what they learn from you that they're going to want to come back for more and more and more. And that is the key. Now, someone in another group of mine asked another question about email automation, and that was a client of hers came to her and said, "Hey, please add me to your email list." So she said, "Sure." But you know what? She didn't have an email list. And so she said in the group, "What am I supposed to do? I have someone who's so interested to receiving my emails, but I don't have an email list to send out. So now I need to create one email for her every week. So this is what I suggest." Number one, go through all your live videos, go through your blogs, go through whatever content you've created in ways that you didn't even realize you created it. Transcribe your videos, create little tidbits and pull them out so that you have topics to write on. Step two, write some simple emails. They don't have to be long and elaborate, just a simple paragraph would do. Hey, I just wanted to pop into your box to let you know about this. Tell them what this is. Maybe it's a story. If you check out one of my older podcasts about getting back up, I share a story with you. So you want to come up with some stories that relate to a lesson that they can learn from. Maybe you want to share something that you recently learned that you want them to know. Maybe you want to give a piece of your expertise so that they can get really clear on whatever it is they're having trouble with that you help them solve. So think about what you can write them. And then I want you to think about the frequency of your emails. My email subscribers get 2 emails a week, unless I'm doing a launch, and then they'll get a few more. But maybe that's too much for you. That's overwhelming to think about. So start small. Maybe send 1 email a week. Maybe send 1 email every 2 weeks. If you are an e-commerce store and you have products to sell, a lot of people like to do a monthly newsletter with some coupons and the newest item that's in stock. So come up with that frequency that works for you, something that you know you can keep up with, and then go out and continue that consistently. Now, to solve the problem about not having enough email subscribers, the next thing you need to do is create a lead magnet, something for free that you can give away in exchange for an email address, and start sharing that link with everybody so that people know that you exist and they'll want what you have to offer in exchange for an email list. And slowly but surely, your email list will grow. If you're having trouble building your list, inside the Social Marketing Academy, I have a course called List Building Brilliance, and it breaks down everything, how you set up your email management system, to email swipe files on what to send out, to how to create your freebie or your, to how to create your freebie or your giveaway, to how to create the funnel, the actual website landing pages to create this freebie opt-in where people will put in their email addresses. All of that is inside the Social Marketing Academy under the course List Building Brilliance. So you can figure that all out there if you need extra help. But basically, you want to create an environment where you're just having this back and forth chit chat with your favorite clients and giving them as much valuable information and content as possible so that they really truly see you as the expert and they want to come back for more. I hope this helps, and I'll see you next time. If you loved this episode, head over to iTunes to subscribe and leave us a review so we can reach more people and share our content with those that can benefit most. And before you go, I want to invite you to join my Social Marketing Academy, where you can master the skills you need to manage and scale your own business or your clients' businesses. This membership will give you all the tools you need to be successful online and teach you how to engage properly with your ideal audience. New courses are constantly being added to the Academy, and you can work through them at your own pace. Check it out now at socialmarketingacademy.org.
Thanks for listening to the Marketing Tips with Meliss podcast at www.marketingtipswithmeliss.com.